After understanding the different methods of dealing with the business risks, let us now understand the nature of business risk. Business risk, as I have always been telling, is a risk which is always associated with the business. Now, getting into this particular topic called as nature of business risk, let us look at the first point. Business risks arise due to uncertainties. See, future is something very much unpredictable in nature. No one can foresee and predict what is actually going to happen in future. We might just say this might happen, but we cannot say this is only will happen. So the perfection cannot be achieved in pretending the future. So as a business is a kind of setup which is dealing with the future and the other aspects, there are so many uncertainties which might be there in the business. The demand might not be there for the product or the business idea that we are dealing with. Some government rules and regulations might change. So various problems because of which business might undergo a lot of risk and uncertainties in future. So business risk majorly arises out of uncertainties of the future. Second thing why the business risk arises is that risk is an essential part of every business. See, every business there is a risk. There is no business in the world which doesn't have any kind of risk. So risk is always part of any kind of business in the world. So the business risk is actually in coordination or in kind of dimension with the kind of business that we are into. If it is a really very big firm, then the business risk will be very high. Or if the investment is very high, the risk also will be very high. If the investment and the business is small in size, the risk also might be a bit smaller in size. But there is also a saying which tells us that you take the higher risk which will fetch you the higher profits. But if you take the low risk, it will always fetch you a lower amount of risk. So as a business part, and business is an economic activity, when we deal with finance and other stuffs, business always involves one or the other risk. And as I said, because of uncertainty, and business risk is always as an essential part of the business. Then the degree of risk depends upon mainly the nature of size of the business. If the nature and the size of the business is very small, then we can say the risk is also very small. If the size of the business is very huge, then the risk is also very huge. The nature also plays a very predominant role in deciding the risk factor of the business. If ours is a business wherein we are dealing with a customer whose taste and preferences keep on changing every now and then, so at that point in time, the risk is very much there with such kind of business. But if we are dealing with any grocery products, so groceries and other foodstuffs are always wanted by people. So the risk over here is quietly or certainly very less. So, and the next point says, the profit is the reward of risk taking. Whenever we take any huge risk, obviously the profit will always be part of it. When the profit is high, that also means that the risk taken by the business person is also very high. If the profit is less, the risk also will be very less. So only we say in economics, saying that higher the risk, higher the profit, moderate the risk, moderate the profit, and lower the risk, lower will be the profit. So profit comes behind a person who is actually taking risks in his business. Risk taking is a very essential part of any kind of business. Now let us look at the various causes of business risk. Business risk, why do they come, and other stuffs. See, one kind of cause for a business risk might be the natural causes or the natural calamities, we call it as. Because of flood, we might undergo some business risk. Because of earthquake, lightning, heavy rains, these are few of the natural causes which might cause us the business risk. If I'm a normal business person who is selling vegetable on the roadside, I'm a vegetable vendor, for example. If it rains very heavily on a particular day, I might not be able to keep my vegetable stall on the roadside on that particular day. So that's a loss of business for me, wherein I have invested some money on the vegetables, already have bought it and kept it, but it's raining heavily and all the vegetables got spoiled. So that's a kind of risk that I can undergo because of natural causes or the natural calamities. The second cause of risk is like human causes. Human causes might be like dishonesty of employees working in the company, carelessness or negligence of the employees, or if the employees go on a strike all of a sudden, which is an uncontrollable factor. Because of this kind of activities, the employer or the business might undergo a lot of risk. There are a few employees, or there will be a few employees in an organization who are very much dishonest to their work. They will not be doing their work properly. Whenever they get time, they remain idle and try not to do the work as much as possible. That is something called as a dishonesty, or they try and cheat their own company in their work. And there are a few people who are very careless and negligent about the business or the work that they are doing for the business. If you show any one single carelessness in your business, you might undergo very big losses. So that also might be a problem. And the strikes, if the employee is not satisfied, or if the human resources are not satisfied with whatever activities you are giving them or whatever facilities you are giving them, they might go on a strike all of a sudden. They might not work until their satisfaction is being achieved or their problems are being addressed too. So these are the various reasons which we can say the business risk might arise from. The last risk might be something called as an economic risk. This is with regards to the financial matters of the business. If the finance in the company gets stuck somewhere, I have sent some raw materials or products to one of the vendor, but he has still not made the payment. And he says he cannot make the payment for another few days, wherein those stock, whatever I have sent to them, I have made the investment on that, but I have not got any returns on it. So here, I have got stuck on that investment, which has become a dead investment for me. So such kind of economic risks also might arise through our business activities. So these are the various causes because of which we will have the business risk. After understanding business risk in a detailed way, let us move on to the one of the most important topic of this particular chapter, business studies, is starting a business. Now, here we will understand all the basic factors that we will have to consider while we start a new business. The first and the foremost factor that we will have to consider while starting a new business is the selection of line of business. Means, what business am I going to start? What is the business which has got demand in the market, which the people are in need of? What kind of products I should be producing? And how much of profits am I going to get? How far can I sustain in this particular industry? So these are the different ways in which you think while selecting a new line of business when you are about to start a new business. So the first thing, as I said, is to select the line of business wherein you want to start the business with. And then comes the size of the firm. Size of the firm also plays a very predominant role in starting the business. If your business is very small in size, it can be started very easily in a very quick point of time or in a very quick span of time. But if your business is very huge, it has to be registered and it takes a longer time to incorporate and make that business come into existence itself. It involves a lot of planning, commitment, coordination, accumulation of lot of resources like human resource, natural resources, raw materials, plant and machineries and other stuffs. So the capital investment also becomes a very bigger task when you go for a bigger size of firm. So the second thing that we have to consider as a factor of business is the size of the firm which we are going to start the business with. Next thing is the choice of form of ownership. Ownership, it might be a single owner called as OPC, one person company, wherein only one single person might invest all the money and take care of the business. We might also run the business on the basis of partnership. We can ask other people also to invest their time and money on the business. Or we can also run a joint stock company wherein we invite the public to make the capital investment and I take care of the business through the public's money. Now, it is very important factor for the person, whoever is starting the business, to firstly decide on the form of ownership that they want to carry on. If it is a single person, trust me, he has got all the talent or all the freedom to take all the decisions. But if the business undergoes losses, only he will have to face all the losses. But if it is a partnership firm, he can take idea from few people and also the investment from few people. If at all the business undergoes losses, the loss will be shared amongst all the partners. The same with joint stock company also, wherein thousands of people will invest on the company, right? So the selection of form of ownership is also a very important factor when you are going to start a new business. Then we have got something called as the location of business enterprise. Where I am going to start my business? That particular place, has it got very good demand for my business, what I am going into? Will I have easy access to the raw materials, transportation, market, and also how about the infrastructural facility in that particular locality where I am going to start my business? So considering all these factors, we should decide upon the location of the business where I am going to start my business in. Then the next factor is the financing, the proposition. Finance is said to be the lifeblood of organization. Finance is a very crucial thing for all the business. So after we plan everything, the first and the foremost thing that we have got to worry about is the finance for that particular business which I am going to start now. How much of capital or finance is required? How I am going to acquire all that capital? How I am going to use that capital? Where am I going to invest? On what all resources I am going to invest? How will I get the return on my investment, which is a very crucial factor for all the business? So financing the proposition is one more very important business factor that we have got to think when we are going to start a new business. The next factor is physical facilities of the firm. Whenever we have got to start any business, first of all, we might need land, building, the office space. It might also require some factory outlet, the company layout, everything, and also the plant and machinery, the raw materials. All these things are considered to be as the physical facilities to start a business. Before starting any business, the person who is entering into the business or starting that business will have to chalk out what are the different facilities that he requires to start his business. Getting those physical facilities also depends on the amount of capital invested on the business. So based on the capital investment, that will be the physical facilities for that particular business. The next point is the plant layout. If ours is a manufacturing concern or a manufacturing business wherein we produce something, converting the raw materials into finished goods. So at that particular point in time, it so happens that the plant layout or the factory outlet or the factory store, what we call it as factory space, that plays a very predominant role. Whenever I am going to plan out for my plant layout, I should follow all the rules and regulations which are laid down by the Factories Act of India. So whatever are the rules and regulations, whatever safety measures I have got to take in a particular plant layout or the factory layout, what are the resources I should be using, what are the resources I should not be using, do's and don'ts in that particular plant layout, everything will have to be properly chalked out before setting up a plant layout. The next factor is the competent and committed workforce. It so happens that without a competitive and a committed workforce, getting success in business is too very difficult. Being successful in a business also depends a lot on the workforce or the HR people or the employees that we have got in our organization. If they are competent enough and they are very much composed or committed enough, we can create wonders using that HR workforce. But if they are not satisfied with whatever facilities they are being given or whatever work they have been assigned with, trust me, getting success in business will remain a very big dream for that particular business person. So the workforce also plays a very important role, and this is also one of the key factors which has to be thought about while starting a new business. Then comes something called as tax planning. Tax is something which we'll have to pay to the government based on the amount of turnover we have in our business. If ours is a small-scale industry, obviously there is a lot of tax rebate being given for small-scale industry. So first thing, we should identify to which sector our business goes to. Is it going for a kind of ancillary industry or a kind of small-scale industry, large-scale industry or a medium-scale industry? So based on that, there are many tax plans or tax proformas which are available. So whatever taxes we have got to pay, those has to be paid. And at times the company can act very smartly if they start their investment on some other aspects also, or if they borrow some loans to perform their business. At times they might not pay tax by showing all those transactions as what they have taken as the loans from the banks or other financial institutions. So tax planning is also one of the most important basic factor while starting a new business. And now the last and the most important factor, which has to be considered as one of the most important factor while starting a new business, is launching the enterprise. After we plan everything, finance, capital, the resources like human resource, raw materials, whatever the plant layout, everything which is required to start a new business, then the most important factor is how to launch that new enterprise. When is the right time to enter into the market? All these things will have to be taken into consideration before we start our enterprise. So the timings also matters a lot when we are entering into the market. So there are a few products which the business comes out with which are actually seasonal kind of products. So we should see whether the season is very much comfortable for us to enter into the market or suitable for us to enter into the market. So these are the various factors which has to be permanently and like very importantly considered while starting any kind of new business.